Nivellen. In Redania, in the woods near Muravel, there's a secluded manor. This manor was said to be the home of a monster, and tales of the manor and its inhabitants were used by the locals to scare their children. Nivellen was from a young age always quite sickly. His father and grandfather were both leaders of a gang of cutthroats. They made a fortune doing so, and the family was very wealthy. After his father was killed, Nivellen inherited the leadership over the gang. He enjoyed being a criminal and leader of the gang, but this came soon to an end. One day they decided to raid the nearby temple in Gelibol. The gang wanted Nivellen to rape the young priestess there, so he would officially become a man in their eyes. He did, and just before the priestess killed herself, she cursed Nivellen. She told him that he was a monster in human skin, and would become a monster in a monster's skin. Unknown to the group at the time, the temple was a temple of the cults of Gorm Ach Terra, and the curse worked. After a few days, Nivellen turned to a monster. When the servants in the manor saw Nivellen, they fled. While in a confused rage, he discovered that the manor reflected how he felt, as while his servants fled, furniture flew across the rooms. After being alone in the manor for a while, a merchant appeared in the manor's courtyard, who tried to pick a rose from a rose bush that belonged to Nivellen's aunt. He told the man, being desperate from his loneliness, that he had to choose between his life and giving his daughter for 1 year. The merchant returned with his daughter, and the daughter stayed with Nivellen for 1 year. After the year was over, he gave the daughter a large amount of gold and gemstones. Soon word spread around the town, and more merchants came along to deliver their daughters to him. And so on, each year, Nivellen had one merchant daughter at his house, which he rewarded with gold and gemstones at the end of the year. This continued for several years, until one decided she wanted to stay with him. Nivellen was cursed for 12 years before Geralt came along. He and Geralt spoke a while, and Geralt discovered that he wasn't truly a monster, since he was able to touch his witcher medallion. They spoke about the curse and if it was possible to break it. Geralt at the time didn't know how to break it, and soon after left as Nivellen assisted. When leaving, Nivellen told Geralt while giving Roach a pat on the head that animals liked him. This led to Geralt returning to the manor in the early morning to find suspicions were true. The woman that stayed with Nivellen was not human, but a Bruxa, by the name of Farina. She and Geralt started fighting. After a few minutes, Nivellen came out of the house. The Bruxa attacked him as well. After a fight, Nivellen drove a wooden pole through the Bruxa, and while dying she tried to kill Nivellen, since if she couldn't have him, no one could. Geralt cut off the head of the Bruxa. As the Bruxa died, Nivellen turned back into a human. By having his love killed, the curse was broken and he was normal once again. This was all part of the story Grain of Truth from The Last Wish. There are some minor references, I would say, in these games. In The Witcher 3, also Skellige, there is the DLC quest, I believe Skellige's Most Wanted it's called. In this quest, Geralt has to convince some monsters that he's a good person, and one of the deaths the werewolf is angry about on him is the death of Farina, the Bruxa that died in this story. Alright, that's it.
So what? What about Farina? The Bruxa with the fondness for blue roses from Nazair. He showed her no mercy.
Farina killed many an innocent. I had to do something, but I've helped monsters aplenty.
Yes? Who?